Rice is the staple food of Sabah people. And Tapai, the most iconic Sabah wine, is brewed from rice too. Tapai is more than just an alcoholic drink. It's a glue that connects Sabahans from different ethnicity, and rice is for our stomach and Tapai is for our soul. A spiritual drink. When North Borneo, now Sabah, was ruled by British, some Westerners lost their heads for not respecting the local drinking culture. In 1913, British imposed Tapai tax on Marut people, on top of forced labor and various other taxes. The Marut people were fuming. First time ever in Sabah history, Marut from Kaini now, Tenom Dan Pensiongan united to form a Murut nation led by Antu Rosantanom, who crushed the British forces with his nearly 1,000 head-hunting warriors until 1915. A research paper from the National University of Malaysia, UKM, explains the causes well. Here is an excerpt from the paper. What the British failed to realize was the social significance of drinking. It was essential in all types of ceremonies such as birth, death, the harvest festival, weddings, house building, settling feuds, honoring guests, etc. For this reason, the native liquor tax can be seen as an infringement of Murut social life. There, Murut, main grievances were the taxes on Tapai and the Ladung tax for felling of jungle. Callistus Fernandez, contesting colonial discourse, rewriting Murut history of resistance in British North Borneo from 1881 to 1915. Kadays and Dusun people, the largest indigenous group of Sabah, believe that there is a spirit named Bombarion, who dwells in paddy and its well-being is critical for a bountiful harvest. The making and drinking of Tapai comes with many ritualistic practices, to show respect to Bombarion. When a Sabahan looks at you, touches his throat lightly with fingertips, as if he is having a sore throat, and says house, thirsty, he is signaling for a drink in a playful way. You can respond by saying aramiti, a verb or noun which means drink happily together or to drink until our faces are red. The drink can be beer, tapai, and other alcoholic drink. Types and taste of tapai. Tapai is a collective term for many wines in Sabah. Though tapai is commonly translated as rice wine, other food materials such as tapioca and pineapple are used in place of rice too. Every Sabah ethnic groups and districts may have their own version of tapai because of different ingredients. For example, a bit of tobacco shreds or cinnamon powder would be added to give tapai a special flavor. Rice wine has many names such as tapai, talak, lihink, linutau, kino pasa and kinnu pi. The wines brewed from tubers of cassava, tapioca, are called montoku, potent, or kinomalok. The coconut flower stems can produce pinkish sap that is famous for making tawak, toddy or bahar. Tapai varies in tastes such as bittersweet, sour, sour sweet and plain. Tapai with bittersweet taste is considered the best quality, and plain taste is the worst. Tapai is rich in carbohydrates, polysaccharides, and alcohol. Generally tapai is quite potent, with alcoholic contents ranges from 0.05 to 50%. Sometimes even up to 70%, so it can knock out a lightweight drinker fairly quick. In my experience, never mix tapai with beer, unless you have a bed to fall onto, right after a swift blackout. Traditionally, tapai is brewed and stored in ceramic jars, the highly priced assets that are treated as symbol of wealth and valuable bride price in history. Lihink vs Tapai. Lihink is the most popular type of tapai. Both tapai and lihink are brewed with the similar methods. Glutinous rice, sticky rice, is used in brewing lihink, and tapai uses normal and brown rice. The key difference between tapai and lihink is, lihink has the sediments, rice and yeast particles, segregated from tapai, so lihink is more refined and appears as a translucent and beautiful amber liquid. It turns dark when aged, even better. In contrast, tapai is cloudy due to its residues. Lihink is also fermented for long time, 2 or more months. Therefore, tapai is a raw wine stored and served in jar, mainly for self-consumption, while lihink is more marketable and better for preservation. Same as tapai, lihink can be made from rice, tapioca, or pineapple. In fact, lihink is also widely used in cooking of some delicious dishes such as lihink chicken and drunken crabs. Adding lihink to tuarun fried noodle also enhances its aroma. You can even make lihink ice cream. There are a few Sabah entrepreneurs who are really passionate about making top quality lihink, and they want lihink to evolve and walk out of kampong, village, to become a household brand. Look at the lineup of Li Hink below. You will be impressed to see how creative the Li Hink products can be. This is not a sponsored post. 1. Li Hink Nilan. Li Hink Nilan is a homemade rice wine brand originated from Pinerampunk. Mrs. Honalin Putin, the founder of Li Hink Nilan, has been making Li Hink for over 50 years, using the traditional methods inherited from her grandparents. I like the classy bottling and Sumazo Dancers label of Li Hink Nilan, which make it a very presentable souvenir or gift. 2. House of Li Hink, Hall. Eve Jun, from Papar, initiated Hall in Kuala Lumpur, then slowly branching to Sabah in July 2020, and now she is looking forward to set up a production center in Phuket, Thailand. The Li Hink of Hall is pure rice wine without added sugar and water. Besides classic Li Hink, Hall also creates Li Hink that contains herbs such as ginger, cinnamon, ginseng, kumbarango, tongkat ali, or kachip fatima to boost its health value. Hall also invests in R&D on production of premium Li Hink by standardizing the quality factors such as fermentation time, type of yeasts, stringent hygiene, controlled temperature, and quality measurement, under the guide of champion Li Hink guru. Hall is also in the midst of building an education center to promote Sabah rice wines in Kuala Lumpur. This center will be the only research center where visitors can learn about Sabah rice wine and have a taste of the seven wonders of Li Hink at the end of the tour. 3. Kasarahan Li Hink. Kasarahan is a Dusun word which means reminiscing or thinking back to the old days. You know, red wine goes well with certain meat. Many years ago, I discovered that chilled Li Hink and fruits make a yummy combo. Therefore, I'm so delighted to find that fruity Li Hink does exist. I tried the mango Li Hink from Kasarahan and really like it. The available fruit flavors are rambutan, mango, banana, grapes, pineapple, apple, and soursop. These Li Hink are fermented from real fruits, which requires different brewing techniques. Drinking Tapai. Tapai is also known as the Happy Feying Brew. It's an integral part of Kadazan Dusun and Murut cultures, which view Tapai as the spiritual energy or the life force of the rice spirit, Bombarayan. To sip the Tapai when offered is honoring the Bombarayan and the host. Bonding and friendship are strengthened when everyone come together to socialize and sip Tapai during rituals, celebrations, and festivals. Tapai Sipping Party of Murut, Tiaman. The Tapai Sipping Party is an intangible cultural heritage of Borneo because it is such a unique social gathering, which would remind you of the Japanese tea ceremony, Sado, or Chado. Unfortunately, due to hygiene concerns, Tiaman culture would change. Now drinking from a personal jar, thumpong, bamboo cup, suki, or plastic bottle is more preferred. In Murut traditions, Tapai is not drunk from a cup or container but sipped through a tube straw, straight from the wine jar. First, guests are invited to a longhouse, where the host has one or more jars filled with Tapai ready for sipping. The lid is lifted off and the opening is covered with shallow cup of banana or tarap leaves. Clean water is then poured into the jar until it is full. After a few minutes, the water will dilute with Tapai and fit for drinking. Before drinking, the host, or lead drinker, Momu Ern, recites a short pre-drinking prayer called Mong Imbalat to seek blessing and protection from Bombarayan so everyone is free from sickness, poisoning and misbehavior associated with the drinking session. Next, the long straw or siyaporn, tusuk, pierces through the leaf cover and insert inside the jar. Now the guests can take turn to sip the tapai from the jar. When tapai is dry up after some rounds, more water is added and the sipping continues until the wine becomes tasteless, then new jar would be open for more drinking. The drinkers can eat some salted meat, fish, vegetables, and other thirst-provoking tidbits nearby the jar during drinking intervals. The drinking session is accompanied by the gong beating, or singing of folk songs or drinking chants. However, such merry-making actions are forbidden in funeral ceremony and certain rituals. It is a common custom that the tapai in the jars must be finished. At the end, most guests would be so drunk and lay around the floor. Drinking etiquette. You must be respectful to the host and other guests. To avoid leaving a bad impression, the following is a list of don't. 1. Tapai sipping is meant to be a friendly event. Fighting and quarreling won't be tolerated. 2. It's impolite to refuse the offer to drink. Even if you don't drink, just sip a bit to wet your lip to give face. 3. Don't complain to the host if the tapai doesn't taste good. You would insult the host. 4. Don't blow the straw while sipping. Don't pull it out of the jar. Don't touch the straw while someone is sipping. 5. Don't sneeze, spit or vomit while you sip. 6. Don't overtake other drinkers in queue. 7. Be mindful of your manner when you are drunk. The elders will observe your personality. A disaster if you act like a party pooper in front of your crush and her parents. 8. Don't just take the Topai snacks without drinking. 9. Though you are high on alcohol, don't get overly friendly with the wives and daughters of others. 10. Don't move the jar without permission from the host. 11. Don't step over the jar or the food. Please don't drive after drinking. You can sleep over, or have a designated driver or taxi to send you home safely.